Eric Vollmers, Calgary Herald, Calgary Herald 09.29.2017. Aaron Carter and Grace Glowacki from the film Suck It Up, which will screen as part of the closing gala of the 2017 Calgary International Film Festival. Calgary Herald Spotlight Suck It Up will screen Saturday at Theatre Junction Grand at 7:30 p.m. as part of the closing gala of the Calgary International Film Festival. Aaron Carter says it was like summer camp for adults. On the surface, that may seem like a strange comparison when discussing a film that deals with grief, loss and regret. Suck It Up may be funny, but meatballs it is not. Still, the actress says the feeling among cast and crew during production of the comedy-drama was anything but somber, particularly when shooting at a family cabin near Invermere, where most of the film takes place. It was just the most spectacular time, she says. Invermere really is a character in the film. That's what is so beautiful about it. It adds such an intimacy to the film. This small-town vibe is so palpable. The cabin belongs to the family of Grace Glowacki, who is Carter's coster in Suck It Up. They were roommates in Toronto when they hatched the idea of a female buddy comedy. Both were born in Edmonton, although Carter was raised in Calgary. While they didn't know it at the time, both had also spent their childhood summers at cabins in Invermere. Still, that wasn't really the connection that led to the two actresses developing Suck It Up, which will screen Saturday as the Calgary International Film Festival's closing gala. Glowacki and Carter had co-written and costarred in the 2014 short Bonfire, which also focused on women in friendship and mostly took place at a cabin near the lake. Developing a feature seemed like the next logical step. Really, I think it just came from a frustration from the types of characters we were seeing, Carter says. We weren't super excited about anything. Nothing was really the types of people we wanted to be playing. So we just thought we would write stuff for ourselves. So the pair enlisted screenwriter Julia Hoff to pen the script, giving her the bare bones of what they wanted: an unabashedly Canadian female buddy comedy road movie that somehow involves a cabin in Invermere, which the Glowacki family just happened to have at the ready. She came back to us with this great story of two friends who are really having trouble finding each other after losing somebody so close to them, Carter says. Suck It Up begins in Calgary, where the obsessively organized Faye Carter returns to help out her estranged friend Ronnie Glowacki. Ronnie has descended into a haze of alcoholism and self-destruction after the death of her brother, who was also Faye's first love. In desperation, Faye whisks Ronnie off to a cabin in Invermere in a vintage Mustang in hopes that a change of scenery will help. Through self-examination and more than a little debauchery, each woman takes their own funny and poignant journey to sort through their grief, loss and anger. Armed with an early draft of a screenplay, the pair cold-called St. John's native Jordan Canning, who had recently picked up a prestigious $120,000 Women in the Director's Chair prize. Canning had made waves at the Toronto International Film Festival in 2014 with her debut feature We Were Wolves, a film that also happened to be set mostly in a family cabin. Canning fell in love with the script, with the characters and the premise. For the next 2 years, the four women continued to develop the idea. What was always so wonderful about this is right from the get-go was the two leads were attached to it, says Canning. It's so rare that you get to spend so much time with the actresses who are going to carry your film, and that they could be so involved with the script evolving, and with the story work we could do, and character work we were doing. All of us were gaining this comfort and love for one another. By the time we were shooting, we knew the story and the characters inside and out. They were living with these characters for years. I think that's what made this so amazing and special, how deeply in their bones these characters were by the time we were shooting. The characters deepened, as did the themes. And while it certainly didn't lose its sense of humor or adventure, the film also became less an overt comedy and more of a moving slice of life examination of how people deal with tragedy differently. This kind of tone is really the tone I like to work in the most, says Canning. A lot of my work fits in this place, where humor and drama intersect. I think as long as you're always playing the honest emotion, that's how the comedy comes out. Julia is great at that. She doesn't write jokes. She doesn't push the comedy. It comes out in honest ways.